I'm in a hotel room in Nashville, Tennessee, where I'm holding a seminar, and in a couple of days, I will be on my way to Ukraine for my annual mission to teach young men and women, more than 1,000 of them, future pastors, people in full-time Christian service, to cast out demons and set people free. I look forward to it each and every year, and I thank you for your prayers and support that help me on my way. When people meet with me for personal one-on-one spiritual encounters, there are two things that concern me. First of all, can we forensically and objectively determine that this individual has demons? And secondly, are they truly prepared to be delivered? You know, some people just aren't ready to be delivered. They want to be delivered. They're tired of the torment. Of course, they want to be free. But some of them are a little bit like the description that Jesus gave when he said that no one having put his hand to the plow and looking back is fit for the kingdom of God. In Luke 11:26, Jesus also mentions what happens if demons are cast out and the person does not fill up that area of their life with the Holy Spirit and with positive Christian activity. If they don't do the right thing after getting free from the wrong thing, they run the risk that that demon and seven others worse will be back. So when an individual gets free, it is so important that they don't look back, that they turn their backs completely on everything that got them demonized in the first place. They have to turn their backs on the anger, the rejection, pornography, the addictions, the bitterness, the witchcraft, all the evil that was there that caused them to be tormented by the enemy. Don't look back. Remember Lot's wife. I've been thinking a lot about Lot's wife lately. I was reading in a biblical study book, one I really enjoy and I'm spending some time in, about what scholars think regarding what really happened with the destruction of Sodom and Gomorrah. Most of you know that story from Genesis chapters 18 and 19, how the three angels came and warned Abraham. His nephew Lot and his family were in the city of Sodom and Gomorrah, and Abraham bargained with those angels to try to save the cities. Well, that couldn't be done. They came, they warned Lot and his family. And the angels gave them three basic instructions. First, get out. Secondly, don't look back. And thirdly, keep moving until you reach your destination. In this case, the city of Zoar. There's something interesting that most people don't notice. There's much talk about Lot's wife looking back and being turned into a pillar of salt. But that's not what happened. The destruction didn't come until after, many believe, that she went back to Sodom and Gomorrah, and she was there when the fire fell, and that sulfuric fury literally crystallized her body. We have to leave sin behind. People who get delivered have to make changes. And I encourage you, if you want to be set free, if you want to stay free and live free, you must be willing to turn your back on sin and Satan and all the issues that held you in bondage before you were delivered. Don't look back. Don't go back. Remember Lot's wife.